In this video, I want to pick up where I left off on this gear component for the Waterwheel exhibit for the American Precision Museum. In the last video, programming this gear was done inside of a basic Mastercam mill license. I used a wireframe-based 2D swept toolpath to program the inner 3D surface portion. However, there has been a design revision on this part with added reinforcement ribs, complicating the program. This will necessitate exploring other options to machine this part, as 2D swept will not work. The circular nature of this part would be an ideal candidate for a 3D HST spiral toolpath. Unfortunately, utilizing a 3D HST toolpath on this complicated set of surfaces is not an available option with a mill product level license. This does not mean that we've hit a dead end just yet. In the mill product level, Mastercam does support single surface machining with all surface finishing toolpaths. Launch a spiral toolpath and in the parameters, select a single surface and set the walls and floors to zero. Under the tool page, select the ball end mill. On the cut parameters page, set the inner and outer radius, leaving a large step over for now. Mastercam does generate some toolpath, but as expected, they are limited to a single surface or solid face for each operation. If I add any other selections to the model geometry page, the toolpath fails to generate due to the restrictions of my current Mastercam license. Now I could go through and program this face by face. Without the ribs, that would be feasible, but as is, I would probably run into blend issues and even gouges with adjacent surfaces that the toolpath may not be aware of. This would get extremely tedious on these tiny surfaces around these structural ribs. It's likely just not worth the effort. Instead, let's explore some new tools in Mastercam 2022 that can convert this collection of faces into a single surface, allowing for full machining of this 3D part while still inside the Mastercam mill product level. Start by converting this solid model to surfaces. On the ribbon bar, go to the Surfaces tab. Launch Surfaces from Solids and select the surfaces with a shift click, deselecting the outermost surface. In the panel, keep the original solid. Click OK, and this will create the surfaces on the active level. Next, use the fill holes command to cap the center keyway and shaft bore. Turn on level 6 to find a circular surface. This is the surface that will drive the UV lines on the new single surface that will be created. Launch the Edit UV Surface function to get a feel for the UV lines that will be used. Here you can modify the UV line density and direction if desired. This surface data would be very important if I plan to use a flow line toolpath. Since we are using a spiral toolpath, the resultant UV lines will be ignored anyway and are of less importance. Exit out of the function. In preparation for creating the new surface, set the active level to 8. Launch Overflow UV. Ensure that the function is using a C-plane projection method and pick the flow surface. Since the C-plane is top, Overflow will auto-select the surfaces underneath it, and the UV lines we viewed before will be projected down. When creating new surfaces like this, it is critical to specify a tolerance and utilize the preview. For this part, the default tolerance of 0.02 millimeters should be more than tight enough. When the preview calculates, you can see that the new single surface will not vary from the original surfaces by more than the specified tolerance. This will allow machining of the finished part well within specification. If the finished part dictated a tighter tolerance, it would be imperative to adjust that here. The toolpaths can only machine as accurate as the CAD data that is fed into them. Accept the results and create the new surface. Shut off all other entities in the Levels Manager. We are left with a nice, clean, single surface that will be easy to program. Relaunch the previously created spiral toolpath and reselect this new single surface. generate the toolpath. Let's look at the result in backplot. Spiral yields a nice, clean toolpath. At this point, I could go back into the toolpath parameters, tighten up the step over, and be ready to run it at the machine. The resultant toolpath would leave a great surface finish and a beautiful part. By utilizing the new Overflow UV function, programming complex 3D parts with a regular Mastercam mill license is possible. Here I showed using this as a tool for Mastercam mill, but all other product levels benefit greatly from this enhancement. Overflow UV has great power in affecting resultant U and V surface data for better utilization of flowline toolpaths in both 3 and 5 axis. Overflow also shines as a CAD tool for imported models. It can bridge small gaps or missing sliver faces on suspect areas that could otherwise be problematic. Adopting this new Mastercam functionality into your workflow can greatly increase programming efficiency and your overall finished part quality.